I'm Chris Delaney. I'm an engineer in the planning section of the Sonoma County Water Agency, and we're out here today with our first implementation of the outlet channel management plan. This management plan was a requirement of the biological opinion, and the goal here is to create a channel in which you convey the flow in a unidirectional manner from the estuary to the ocean. Historically, we've always breached the estuary. When we breach it, basically the estuary becomes tidal. This meaning that you have outflow from the estuary into the ocean at low tide, but then you have inflow from the ocean into the estuary at high tide. And the goal here is to just have unidirectional flow from the estuary to the ocean. And this is to improve water quality in the estuary for rearing steelhead, which reside in the estuary in the summertime.
Hi, my name's John McKeown. I work for the National Marine Fisheries. We're an agency within the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. California river mouths have been shown to be really highly productive for rearing juvenile salmon and steelhead. So we're working with the Water Agency to maintain the most productive habitat possible, while at the same time carrying out the Water Agency's mission of flood control. As the lagoon level comes up, starts inundating all the edges and fringes and the shoals, University of Washington has documented last year during about a month-long closure that in those shoal areas they have really high production of isopods and amphipods, and by having that stable water surface elevation, not fluctuating with the tides, allows these amphipods and isopods to complete their life cycle in this warm shoal edge water. And then studies by the Sonoma County Water Agency have shown that the salmonids, the steelhead that are occupying the lagoon, feed really heavily in those areas. And so we're hoping that by this action, they can maintain the productivity of the lagoon, and it's still not cause flooding around the town of Jenner.